Hey everybody, Katawa Shoujo returns! A couple weeks ago we finished up Hanako's path, this week we're gonna start up on Emmy's path. And this is the decision gate you want to start on, with the nurse, and you got the decisions yes and maybe. Maybe it takes you towards a different direction, yes will take you on Emmy's path, it's the starting point for it, so let's hit the yes button. Yeah, I promise, definitely. He studies me for a moment and then shrugs, smiling again. Okay, that's more like it. If you go to the school track tomorrow morning, you'll meet my spy, who probably has no qualms offering consultation to you if you want to jog a bit. Consultation? See you around. He leaves with a wave of his hand and no answer, and I walk to Rin, who has been waiting, idly leaning against the hallway wall and staring at the pale lighting fixtures in the ceiling. Alright, we're gonna skip a little bit of the same stuff here. Once we get to Emmy's scene, I'll do that one again, because I don't mind it. And I might actually attempt Rin's path next year, we'll see. I think Neo is only covering Lily and Shizune as I know right now. He might do part of Rin's path too, but we'll see. Alright, we're on the new day. So, eventually I do rise up, swallow the morning medications, and put on my old soccer clothing. Thanks to my condition, I was exempted from taking part in gym classes at Yamaku, so I didn't get issued with a gym outfit. I'd order some to cover such a contingency, but wearing my old soccer clothes is kind of nostalgic. I can't use them for that anymore, so maybe they can get a new life this way. A bit like me. After all, if I'm going to start taking care of myself, I can't afford to slack around. I'll start from the basics. Basics which include keeping the rest of my body in shape, along with what little I can do to strengthen my heart. Maybe then I can go back to something approaching a normal life, or at least something where I'm less likely to fall over dead at any minute. I'm surprised to discover that I'm not the only one present at the track. Not just that, but it's a face I've seen before. The prosthetic leg girl who bowled me over in the hallway yesterday is running on the track lithely, like a half-mechanical gazelle. What was her name again? It was a short one, but I can't remember. She seems to be running laps at a somewhat easy lope, her prosthetic legs clacking rhythmically on the hard track surface. I wonder what reason she has for running this early in the morning. Maybe it's something akin to mine, and the nurse is oppressing the poor girl to jog just like he is oppressing me. I certainly wouldn't be here if it weren't for my health, and is prompting me to do so. And even with things being like they are, it's only because I wanted to get it out of the way early. The fact that I would be less likely to encounter someone who would witness my pitiful attempts to get in shape was merely a happy accident. I'd leave, but it seems that my former assailant noticed me on her last lap. She waves at me cheerfully and jogs over.
Good morning! Your name is Hisao, right?
She grins, seemingly pleased that she'd remember my name.
You may not remember me. Emmy, I knocked you over in the hall yesterday. Miss Ibarazaki!
She imitates Misha imitating Shizune, failing to get the same kind of subdued lilt into her high-pitched voice. How could I forget such a, blunt introduction? Emmy has the decency to look vaguely apologetic for a moment before giggling.
Yeah, sorry about that. Again.
Well, so long as you don't make a habit of it, I suppose I'll be fine.
Great!
I'm not sure she realized I was joking. So, the spy consultant the nurse was talking about, is that actually you?
That's right!
Oh. I was expecting someone from the nursing staff, to be honest.
What? Are you saying I don't look like I could be a spy?
No, this is more like a relief. I was afraid he would have someone to watch my every move. Unless you are here to do exactly that.
No, I'm here for my own reasons. The nurse just asked me if I had seen a messy hair transfer student who looks like he's kind of lost around the track.
So why are you down here? Emmy strikes a dramatic pose.
Training!
For what?
Track!
Ah, I see. You're on the track team then? Emmy nods enthusiastically.
Yep, I'm one of the better runners too.
And modest about it too.
Hey, you should join up. It's good exercise, you know.
I think that much activity is probably out of the question for me. Nah, I'm not even sure that I really like running all that much. Plus, I'm just not into organized sports, you know? It's true, I never even really got that much into soccer. I mean, I'd run around with my friends and all, but that was really the only reason I ever played. It wasn't for the glory to be found on the field, that's for sure. Emmy seems to understand my meaning.
I see. Not that into the whole organization thing. But now that you're here, I guess we're going to run together, huh?
What? Sure, I guess. Emmy seems pleased.
Are you going to warm up?
Real men don't warm up.
Oh no, you should always warm up. Bad Hisao!
She scolds me enthusiastically, but then smiles and leans closer.
I hate warming up too.
She laughs suddenly.
Heck, and I don't even have to stretch my legs!
As if to confirm her statement, she bounces up and down a couple of times, giving a passing impression of standing on a pair of springs. Her leg blades seem to be quite elastic.
Let's go!
So we both take off around the track, and I can immediately see that she wasn't lying about being good at running. Emmy moves fluidly, throwing herself into the run with a sort of wild abandon. I find myself concentrating more on running properly. Hands spread, right? And something about hitting on the balls of your feet rather than the heels. I try to match my stride to Emmy's, but it's pretty difficult. Apparently, I'm not very good at this. Maybe Emmy could help me with that sometime. I'm really not feeling up to more than a couple of laps today, and slow to a walk pretty quickly. Emmy keeps running and doesn't seem to notice I've stopped until she passes me a second time. She quickly skids to a halt, breathing steadily in contrast to my own somewhat gasping demeanor.
Finished already?
I hang my head ruefully. Yeah. I'm not in very good shape right now. Emmy nods and then grins at me again. She seems to do a lot of smiling.
Well, the important thing is you started, right? Next time you just have to try to hold out longer, and then longer, and longer, and eventually you'll be great!
I'll keep that in mind. But I think right now I'm going to go get ready for class. Shouldn't you? Emmy shrugs unconcernedly.
Nah, I've got plenty of time.
I notice that she's not wearing a watch. Are you sure? Another careless shrug.
Not really, but I've got to finish my routine. See you later, Hisao!
Yeah, see ya. I'm not sure whether this morning's experiment was a success or a failure, but I'll admit that I do feel slightly good about getting out there this morning. And like Emmy said, I just need to keep at it in order to get better, right? Practice makes perfect, or something like that. It's nice at least to feel like I've taken some semblance of control over my own health. I'll have to try to keep this up. Yeah, a little bit of difference in the dialogue there. I head back to the dorms to wash and change into my uniform, trying to resist the urge to take a really long and hot shower. I'm tired from all the running, so I just want to unwind, but I don't want to break my slowly building routine of getting to school before the morning rush. Yeah, I think you know what's coming up. It's the Kenji shower scene. We're going to skip that. Reading it once was enough. I don't want to put you guys through this again. Kenji can get kind of tedious. A lot of this is kind of the same. I'm actually going to get to that battle scene between Lily and Shizune. I'm actually going to take a different decision gate for that one. So we're going to kind of skip this a bit. I want to see where the difference comes up. I don't know if it's going to stop at the decision gate or not. Hopefully it does. Okay, and we're going to stop there. We're just going to go through this a little bit more. Okay, here we go. Now we got a decision gate. And I think last time we did, hey, come on, cut me and Lily some slack. Now we want to try to stray away from Lily's path, and we're going to do, don't drag me into this, I've done my part. Why am I being dragged into this again? I've done more than enough, I think. If you're angry with Lily, that has nothing to do with me.
Now wait just a second. Are you implying the president is more right in scolding me than yourself?
Ah, damn, I think I could have worded that better. No, I don't know about that, but I mean...
What are you saying, Hee-chan?
It's just that I hardly think it's fair you could say that, seeing that I've helped you guys. The mood has changed. This is like a showdown between two gunfighters now. Well, it was like that before too, but this time Shizune's focus is on me. And so is Lily's. Though she keeps quiet, I'm afraid I inadvertently pissed her off.
Are you saying I'm wrong?
What a dangerous situation. It's too early to argue with you. Yes, I think it's unfair of you to get on my case.
Hee-chan, you want too much, but you have a point. Okay, okay, okay. You're not lazy, Hee-chan.
Shizune pushes her glasses up with her thumb almost approvingly.
That's good. If you're not useless, you shouldn't let anyone say you are. But the next time I say it, it'll really be because you are disappointing me like Miss Class Rep here, so don't let this go to your head.
Lily takes the jab silently, a venomous visage frozen on her face.
Class Rep, Shee-chan says. Don't forget that report, please.
I won't. Would that be all?
Yep.
Then good day to you all. Her voice would cut the air of the classroom into half if it was more tangible. Lily leaves the room, understandably in a bad mood, but still managing to be as poised and calm as usual. Shizune, you really did go a little too far today.
It's true, Shee-chan, just a little.
If I had been expecting Shizune to grudgingly admit I have a point there as well, I think I was expecting too much. She doesn't respond.
Shee-chan thinks you should mind your own business. Hee-chan, we have a few last-minute things to take care of before class. We might be late, so can you please cover for us?
Yeah.
Perfect! Yay! Okay, thanks, Hee-chan!
They walk outside even though there are only 10 minutes left before the bell will ring, signaling the start of class. Hanako doesn't come to the morning class at all, leaving her seat looking empty and lonely in the back of the classroom. I have to tell her that Lily was looking for her if I see her later. After the events of this morning, class is pretty boring in comparison. I turn to pages of my textbook lazily. We've been covering the same amount of pages each day, so reading ahead is more or less giving myself a preview of what tomorrow's lesson will be about. The clock at the front of the room sounds unbearably loud. The teacher hasn't said anything in over 7 minutes, instead opting to cover the board in rows and rows of equations taken directly from the book. The rhythmic clashing of chalk on blackboard seems to synchronize perfectly with the ticking of the clock. I start to copy down the equations just to pass the time, not noticing Misha's head poking over my shoulder until she is almost on top of me. What are you doing? I try to strike a balance between being quiet enough to not draw attention to myself, but loud enough to draw hers.
What are you doing, Hee-chan?
Panic shoots through me as Misha starts talking at her normal volume, and I sputter out a hasty reply, still keeping my voice down despite the fact that she just blew any hope of being discreet I may have had. I'm copying down that stuff. What are you doing? Why so loud?
Ah, really? But it's all in the book. That's why no one else is copying it down.
I know. Why are you so loud?
Why are you so quiet, Hee-chan? It's hard to hear you.
I look around to see if anyone is noticing our conversation, and it's pretty obvious that everyone has, even the teacher. Shizune smiles coyly, and I start to wonder if Misha is doing this because she told her to. Is it because of what happened between her and Lily earlier? This is what I get for trying to be reasonable, for trying to take the middle path. Shizune is way too prideful, although by now I should know to expect that kind of behavior from her. Why are you doing this?
Huh?
Misha is totally oblivious to the awkward stare the teacher is giving both of us, while trying to balance her textbook on one finger. For a brief second it looks as if things could get ugly, but the teacher simply looks away as if it's not worth the trouble. I guess this is a good thing, and I slump back in my seat in relief. The rest of the day passes by uneventfully, and this time I'm able to appreciate that it does. When the bells ring, I'm not in a hurry, so I stay for a while, reviewing what we covered in class today. I prefer to leave last anyway, so I don't have to deal with crowding in the hallways. I notice Shizune and Misha have also stayed behind, talking to someone from another class. Shizune is signing so fast that her hands make noises like swords cutting through the air. Misha is trying desperately to keep up, but it's clear she could barely manage to even understand her. I put my head down. Whatever they're discussing, it looks like serious business. Probably way over my head. Not just that, but Shizune also seems angry, although it could just be her normal severity making it appear so. Shizune signs to the point where her wrists crackle, and Misha struggles to spit it out in word form. Sometimes she trips over herself like she's dealing with tongue twisters, and then on top of that, she has to sign back anything the other girl says. Seems like a rough job. Misha looks tired, like she's about to faint. Luckily for her, their business is soon finished and the girls sit down on their seats again.
Wah, I'm so tired.
She's hanging her head limply on her desk, looking exhausted. Festival preparations must be tough for you. Indeed, the people in this school seem to be taking this festival very seriously. Whenever I see people idling around before and after classes, they're always talking about their plans for it. It's kind of neat to see everyone being so enthusiastic about it. I'm probably the only one who doesn't have something to do. Shizune starts signing at me and Misha perks up, looking at her hands with slightly unfocused eyes. She signs with harsh, heavy, dramatic strokes. Misha translates her signing into speech for me. She does it so well, it's almost like Shizune is actually speaking, transmitting her thoughts directly through Misha.
Well, we're in the student council, you know, so we're pretty busy.
Sarcasm?
Huh?
The tone of Shizune's actions make me think that she is speaking with disdain, but Misha interprets it normally, replacing whatever intent may have been there with her own chipper twist on things. It's still disorienting. I don't think I'll ever get used to it. Never mind. How could I forget? With you two trying to get me to join at least twice a day.
But Hee-chan, some could say the work is too much. It'd be nice if students were to show a little more support for their leadership, some appreciation to the ones who are working so hard to make it all possible. Maybe, for example, a little help. That's asking too much, is it? Yep, help would be appreciated from students like you. If students would show their dedication and school spirit and offer some help, well, I don't exactly need it. But I wouldn't necessarily refuse it, so it would be nice if someone would. Oh, hello.
I look over my shoulder and see Hanako peering timidly into the classroom, most of her body hidden behind the door.
Hey, playing delinquent again?
Hanako blushes hard at Misha's straightforward jab, even if it was only in jest. Shizune stares at her probingly, causing Hanako to look down and start backing away to the point where only her fingers can be seen wrapped nervously around the edge of the door. Maybe she is showing her dislike of Hanako by association of her dislike of Lily. It appears so, and Hanako probably knows it as well. They seem to have momentarily forgotten about trying to get me to stay for the rest of the day. What is it, Hanako?
Has Lily been here? Sorry, Sato is not here. She came by in the morning, though.
Hanako keeps looking uneasily at Shizune, who stares back at her with her usual studying gaze. What is she trying to do? Of course Shizune isn't going to look away, and she is intimidating enough as it is, so I can only imagine how terrified Hanako would be. It is a little funny, though, watching Hanako's reaction to Shizune's normal behavior. This is what happens when two people of two different extremes meet, it seems.
Do you know where she is? If she has any sense in her head, she's in her classroom, working on their festival project, but who knows where that woman is loitering at. She might be slacking off somewhere, just like Hee-chan.
Damn, what is it with Shizune and her need to point out stuff like this? Hanako nods quickly and retreats with haste.
What were we talking about? Oh yeah, we are really working hard to make the festival happen.
And driving other people insane along the way. Well, good luck with that. I stand up to leave, making my exit before either of them manages to berate me anymore for slacking off. The halls are somewhat quiet, as expected. Everyone must be in club meetings or at festival preparations, or both. Shizune's words about being a slacker echo in my head. I feel a bit guilty about not contributing, but I seem to lack the resolve to do something concrete about the matter. For the festival, it's too late already, unless I count helping Shizune and Misha, which I naturally don't. And clubs, I don't know. Maybe I'm not a club type of a person. Halfway through the way from the school building to the dorms, I spot a figure in front of the dorms. Alright, I think this is something different we haven't seen on Hanako's path. We're on a way towards Hanako's path. It's Rin. It looks like she is working on our mural today, too. I walk over to her, but she doesn't seem to notice me approaching. She's sitting on an unupturned box, looking intently at the wall she is painting with a brush held between her toes. The mural has progressed considerably since yesterday, but it's still only half done, as far as I can tell. More colors have appeared and the twisted human-like figures have spread and increased in number. I have to say, the style is quite eye-catching and very unique. Not that I would be knowledgeable about art by any measurable scale, but it's a very nice looking nevertheless. I clear my throat to get her attention, but not startle her so that her concentration won't break. Wait. She doesn't even turn to check who it is. I'll wait. And wait. And wait. And wait some more. Okay. And wait some more. 15 minutes later, I decide that her concentration is indeed unbroken, and also that I have waited long enough to warrant poking her gently on the shoulder to remind her of my presence. Rin turns her head mechanically to my direction, ending up staring at my crotch level. Oh, it's Hisao. She could tell? I would feel a lot less uncomfortable if she would look at my face. An astute observation. Hard at work, I see. The conversation starts as if I hadn't been here for a quarter of an hour already, but it's not a concern, at least it starts. Looking good. It does. The layers of paint hiding other layers of paint, mixing and shaping the human figures really create an impressive look, but Rin looks miffed. You shouldn't comment on works in progress. 7 years of bad luck. Sounds terrible. I guess I'll take it back then. Still, it looks good. I wonder if I get 14 years of bad luck for thinking that. Rin turns back to look at her painting and pokes it with a big toe. Could you mix some of this color? I'm running out of it. She looks down at a half-empty bowl with the remains of the same pinkish paint in it. I didn't really intend to stay and help her with this project, though. I guess I didn't intend to do anything much. I look at Rin. She looks emptily back at me. Just this once. Rin picks up another brush and drenches it in another tone of pale red. There are dozens of similar bowls all around her working area. From the looks of this scene, she could have been sitting there for hours. I wonder if she has. That would mean she'd have been skipping school, though, which I, of course, wouldn't put beyond someone like Rin. I pour a little bit of white and red into the bowl, trying to match the color with the one already on the wall. I can't seem to get it right. It's really inconvenient of her to not mix enough in the first place. Getting it to be exactly the same tone will be impossible, but at least I can try to get as close as I can. Speaking of hard work, isn't that a huge workload for you too? It's such a big painting and all. Oh, I'm not old and bitter enough yet to think like that. I guess you aren't. You guessed right. Legs hurt though. They feel like slugs. Slugs made of sea slugs. Because of the position? Yeah, I like doing it in a horizontal position more, if you know what I'm talking about. But it can't be helped. Can't ask the wall to lay down. Saying that, she stretches herself a little, bending her legs and back far more than a human should flex. It's astonishing how effortlessly she manages her body around. There is a small flinch in her otherwise blank expression, a hint of pain maybe, as she stretches out her calves. Rin must have stamina and dexterity far above a normal person to be able to live like she does, but she's wearing out working on this. Why push yourself so much? Take a break or something at least. Continue tomorrow if it's bad. This gives her a pause. A long one too, feeling like a mental yawn. I don't think so, Hisao. I'm not pushing myself. Sure looks like you are. No, it's not about pushing or pulling or anything related to that kind of thing. There is this boy. A boy? Yes. Where? At the art club. And? He is blind. Oh, how could you paint if you were blind? No idea. So why is he there? That's the point. He is there. She really should speak more than one word at a time to make this feel more like a discussion and less like an interrogation. He can't really do anything that you'd call art, right? But he comes there anyway and paints. Why? I don't know. Why? I don't know. That's why I asked. So? He doesn't paint often, but I think his paintings are very interesting. I'm sure they are. I once tried that, painting with eyes closed. wasn't too interesting, and cleaning up the floor took ages. Didn't try again. But he is becoming better at sculpting. I see. Maybe she was trying to make a point with this. Maybe she forgot she had one. Seems like the art club is full of interesting people. Not really. Pretty blunt statement, and she totally missed the sarcasm. No? Just like I said, they are not very interesting. I usually don't have much interest in people who are not interesting. Maybe you have. Maybe. But that boy is interesting. Maybe I am like that boy, or maybe you are, maybe everyone is. Doing things you can't do just because you can. That's pretty deep, I think. And tell that to her. You're a deep one. Nah, I'm a really shallow and thoughtless person. People say that to me all the time. Did you know I can only think of 4 things at the same time? No, but now I do. Right now I'm thinking of the second floor's girl's toilet, ice cream flavored ice cream, the middle toe, and a haircut. I'm going to need a haircut. She shakes her head around vigorously, letting her short and messy hair ruffle wildly around. I can see that doing it is something she likes to do. We fall silent as Rin treads around absentmindedly, poking some brushes around. The thought about the art club sticks in my head for a while longer. I'm feeling like I'm treading on very unknown territory with art. The way these meetings with Rin go, it's as though I'm starting a smoking habit or something. I should probably stop talking with her. It's not like I dislike her, despite the confusion her being herself causes, and I don't dislike art either. I've even drawn for fun sometimes. I just don't have a real creative drive or any technical skill. So usually if I were to draw something, I'd get white paper syndrome and just freeze completely. That, or I manage to draw something disfigured and promptly get frustrated at my inability to put the picture in my head down on the paper, then call it quits without really even trying to make an effort. Rin clearly doesn't have this problem, but she frustrates me in another way. Being with her is like looking into a mirror that doesn't reflect anything. It makes one question the sanity of the act. Rin sits down on her box, swaying from side to side, apparently comfortable with the uncomfortable silence. She is staring at me again, or maybe over my shoulder. I can't quite figure out where her eyes are focused. I'm thinking of leaving so she can carry on working undistracted and then I can do whatever I'm going to do alone. It's not like I have anything that must be done today. Oh, shoot. Who? Nobody. I just forgot to tell Hanako that Lily was looking for her. Do you know her from my class? Oh, her, the mystery toilet girl. That person is funny. I saw her going to the toilet 5 times during one recess 3 weeks ago. I'm sure it's the world record. It was very mysterious. That's why you call her mystery toilet girl? What other reason could there possibly be? Well, if there is, it's an internal mystery. I didn't follow her in there. Maybe it was the week before that. Could have been. Looking at her makes me hungry. Don't say that. At least, not around her. Rin turns to look at me blankly as if she's not sure why I reproved her. But she doesn't acknowledge understanding any more than before, so I give up at this point. So, do you want to go eat dinner then? No, not yet. Rin has turned her hungry gaze back to the wall, looking slightly more energetic, or at least slightly less lethargic, than she did before. It's as if the wall is an opponent she has to vanquish, something she must overcome before she can indulge in dinner. This is the feeling I get. A weird sense of empathy overcomes me and makes me smile a little to myself. For all her oddity, Rin is pretty cool after all. I'll be going anyway. Have fun! Rin has already grasped a brush and is dipping it into fresh paint, so of course she can't hear me anymore, or doesn't answer anything even if she does. Adhering to the nurse's nagging voice in the back of my head, I set my alarm clock to wake me up early enough to go jogging again. And with that being said, folks, we're going to cut it off here for part 1 of Emmy's Path, so stay tuned for Let's Play Katawa Shoujo Emmy's Path Part 2, when we'll hopefully meet Emmy out on the track and get some more running done. Anyways, see you then, peoples!